What's up guys, today I'm going to share my experience with the Ulanzi D200 Stream Deck, a budget device designed to improve your productivity, streamline live streaming workflows, and add convenience to your everyday tasks. Whether you are a live streamer, a content creator, a programmer, or even an office worker, this gadget can actually help you save time and effort by automating your repetitive tasks. It features like customizable LCD keys, real-time system monitoring, and macro support. It's a versatile tool that adapts to your unique needs. So let's jump right in and check it out. Let's start with the unboxing experience. The packaging is clean and protective, ensuring the device and its accessories arrive safely. Here's what you get in the box. User manual on the top, the D200 Stream Deck controller device protected by the foam on the top and the bottom, a 2-in-1 data cable. This data cable was actually a nice surprise for me as it supports both USB-A and USB-C inputs. I really appreciate this thoughtful inclusion as it eliminates the need for extra adapters. Lastly, you see the stand, which allows you to position the device at a comfortable angle. Now let's talk about the design and build quality of the device and its stand. Stand is made of plastic, while the main device boasts a premium aluminum build that feels nice to hold with its full round design and no sharp edges. It has 13 customizable LCD keys, which I think are made of glass, and each key has a resolution of 196 by 196 pixels per inch, which is plenty given the size of each key. Icons in the keys look crisp and vibrant. The keys have a tactile feel with a satisfying travel distance. It also has actually a 14th key, which is called info window. This info window displays real-time system stats like CPU, RAM, and GPU usage in terms of percentage or time depending on what you have selected in the app. I actually really like this info window, as being able to look at the real-time usage of my RAM is really nice for me, as I can easily see if I am low on RAM and need to close some applications or Google Chrome tabs. Ports-wise, the device has a single Type-C port for connecting it to your computer. While design-wise, this device checks all the right boxes, there is just one flaw. The device rests loosely on the stand without clipping into place. This means that if you try to pick it up, the stand can detach very easily, which can be frustrating. So to lift the device, you must hold it from the bottom of the stand, which feels awkward and inconvenient. So I wish that the stand clipped into the device so that I can easily move it. Before I explain its features one by one, let me actually share my custom use case, like my own personal use case with you. I am a software engineer, so I have programmed an LCD key that launches all my development tools like GitHub, Slack, Android Studio, and work-related Chrome tabs all with a single press. Since I am also a YouTuber and I use Final Cut Pro and Filmora for video editing, so I have installed profiles for both these softwares, and as soon as I launch Final Cut, the D200 automatically loads the Final Cut profile, and if I launch Filmora, the D200 automatically loads the Filmora profile for me. With that, all the quick actions become available depending on the software I'm using, making my editing experience really smooth. Finally, even though I don't do live streams myself, the D200 is perfect for controlling softwares like Obs Studio, with buttons mapped for scene transitions, switching windows, switching cameras, muting the mic, and much more. It supports out-of-the-box support for Obs Studio integration. Now that you are familiar with the device and my setup, let me explain the device features and customization options in detail. Using the UlanziDeck app, which is available for both Windows and Mac, you can customize everything about this device, like icons, labels, and colors, for a fully personalized experience. The app is really easy to use, and all you have to do is just drag and drop most of the time. Each of the 13 LCD keys of the D200 can be programmed to perform specific actions like launching apps, controlling system settings, or even executing multi-step commands. In total, there are four different ways you can customize this device. Number one, multi-step actions are more commonly referred to as macros. This is where the D200 shines. Using the macros, you can combine multiple actions into a single button press. For example, in my case, I have created a macro which performs the following tasks: open Chrome, load Google website into Chrome, load my company GitHub repository website into Chrome, load linear website into Chrome, open Slack, open GitHub, open Android Studio. So my macro performs a total of 7 actions when I press the corresponding LCD key. Similarly, you can create a complex macro to perform any number of tasks. This saves precious time and reduces repetitive tasks, allowing you to focus on your creativity. Number two, app-specific profiles. Since the requirements for quick actions change based on the software you are using, that's where profiles come in. You can save different configurations or layouts of LCD keys as profiles and switch between them based on your needs. Or you can program the D200 to switch between these profiles automatically. So for example, in my case, when I open Final Cut Pro, the D200 switches to Final Cut Pro profile. And when I close the Final Cut Pro, the D200 switches back to the default system profile. This seamless transition makes multitasking a breeze. Number three, expandable key functions with folders and pages. With D200, since you have only 13 programmable action keys, you may think that you are just limited to 13 actions, but that's not the case. You can create folders to nest actions or use pages to handle actions without nesting them. With folders, you can nest multiple actions under one action key, so pressing that action key loads up all the nested actions. With pages, you can add actions without nesting, and pressing the next button on the device will load the actions of the next page on the LCD keys. You can easily configure these pages and folders using the UlanziDeck app. So with pages and folders, the actions that you can configure are almost endless. Number four, marketplace integration. Using the UlanziDeck built-in marketplace, you can download pre-made profiles, plugins, icon packs for popular apps like Final Cut Pro, Ob Studio, Photoshop, and Visual Studio Code. Think of it as a Play Store or App Store on the iPhone or Android phones. In fact, I also downloaded the profiles for Final Cut Pro, Visual Studio Code, and Filmora from the UlanziDeck built-in marketplace. This saves time and effort, especially for beginners who might not want to create profiles from scratch. While I have explained the customization options available in the UlanziDeck app and how easy it is to use the app, I would like to point out that there is a notable drawback in the UlanziDeck app, which is that some of the UI elements in the app are in Chinese, including the file picker, which can make picking applications and files really difficult. This is something Ulanzi needs to address for its global users. It is not a deal breaker, but still an inconvenience, especially for beginners. Although it can easily be addressed using a simple software update, so I'm sure it will get fixed. Pricing wise, at the time of making this video, the Ulanzi D200 Stream Deck is available for a price of just $64 on Ulanzi's official website. Let's conclude this video. I think at just $64, the Ulanzi Stream Deck delivers a good value for money for live streamers, content creators, and productivity enthusiasts alike. Despite its minor flaws, it is a solid choice for anyone looking to automate tasks and simplify their workflow. So if you're looking for something like this, then I would definitely recommend you to give Ulanzi D200 Stream Deck controller a shot. I think you are going to like it. Finally, don't forget to let me know about your feedback. Take care of yourself and see you in the next video. Bye.